Let me get this video queued up because you have to see this. It explains to you the beginning of why you want to eat certain things. It's not your idea. You have other energies inside of your body that need that food. So some of these energies, worms, they eat dead food. So every time you get this craving for dead food, guess what? That's not necessarily you, but it is you. It's another part of you that has grown with you, your baby, per se. And it now is saying, I want to survive. I need some more dead food. Now, this relationship is very similar to what you see with sharks. You know, that's how sharks have these little fish that are swimming on them and eating all the bacteria and the things that, and the mold and stuff that would accumulate on the shark, right? So there's a symbiotic relationship working with the shark and these fish, because the fish also stay around the shark because he runs off the other fishes that are big enough for the shark to really take a chance at eating. But those big fish also eat the small fish that are hanging around the shark, that the shark says, hey, they're too small, I don't even need to eat them, plus they clean me off. You see? So, but what's happening is that when we eat this kind of food, the Cheetos and all these artificial flavors and colors, and believe me, it's almost in everything unless you actually inspect the food and make sure you're getting pure organics, et cetera, because there is an agenda to keep this kind of energy in your system. What happens is that when you eat it, when you consume it, it goes into your body and something's got to digest it. And because you're not calibrated to digest it, you're a mammal, you can't eat these artificial crazy foods. There are now worms and bacteria that live in, like you'll see, there's even worms that grow in minerals and metals. You see what I mean? So you have these different life forms now living inside of you, suggesting what you should do. And it's already been mapped out. There's a fish worm. There's a pork worm. There's a beef worm, there's a chicken worm, and all these worms get inside of the body and grow something to the tune of, some of them, even a foot every year. So some people have these huge worms inside of them that have attached themselves to the person's system. And this is a secret to why the word cancer, if you understand etymology, means the serpent. Sir, of course, let's just take that out. Can is, of course, the indigenous name for the serpent. But if you take the sir part and understand that connects with serpents, because it's a dying cell. It's the low vibratory base pillar frequency that one needs to ascend beyond. So what happens is that inside of the body, you may have developed a symbiotic relationship with a parasite. And then when you look inside the external reality, the same thing is going on, because external reality is only a projection of what's going on in the inside. And that's the key. See, now you should get the motivation that is necessary to begin the cleanse, however it may come about for you, mentally, spiritually, and physically, that kind of cleanse, because you get to the full realization, at least if you can conceive what I'm explaining to you today, of why everything in your direct world may be haywire or out of control for you. I'm telling you today that there is a real system of knowledge that allows you to get in full control of who you are. And there is no overseer or government or these kind of individuals that can impede your progress. But that system in itself, which we talked about, self-substantiation, in the condition in which you've been put in, may seem a little difficult at first, because there are a lot of vibratory frequencies. They're not just the worms. There are other energies that you can't even see, all encouraging you to act and behave and do certain things. And this is where you have to gain control. Now, remember, this is not for me to, I'm not telling you there's ghosts and phantoms and all this stuff around you and they want to kill you and they want you to die. All they want to do is live. If they can do it off your energy, then they're like, thumbs up. Okay? What I'm telling you is that they now need to be given an ultimatum. Either they rise into the higher frequencies that you're going to, because you're the control, you're the soul, you're the sun, you're the energy. So where you decide to move, then everyone else has to go, or else they have to go. You see how that works?